What's up, man? It's your boy Doyle. We're here at Kaiser right now. I'm gonna get my COVID test for safety reasons because a couple of my family members got sick, and a couple of family members of mine are hesitant of getting sick. Some of my family members got more sick than others. I guess it hits everybody different. But at the end of the day, you know, I'm cool, I feel cool, but it's just been in my head, you know. I guess you could call it I was exposed, because I did see one of those family members for a very minimal time, and then I found out they got it 3-4 days later. I feel good, but at the same time, I don't know, you know, if I have something or I don't. So, just to keep my mind at ease, I hope I don't have nothing. I think I don't have nothing. But since I don't know, you know, I have to go to work. I do construction. So without me knowing, just to be safe, I don't wanna, I'd rather know. If I gotta take the day off tomorrow, then I will. I'll let my foreman know the situation. I got tested, waiting for results. Hopefully, I don't know how long it takes. The lady just told me it might take a day to get it. But I wouldn't wanna risk anybody at work neither, you know. So I'm here at Kaiser. It's Sunday. I don't know the day. November, a couple days before Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving is on the 25th. It's like 3-4 days away. I think it's this Thursday and today's Sunday. So pretty much whatever day this is, I'll tune in. But yeah, so I'm right here right now. And wish me luck and good luck to everybody out there too. You know, if you feel like you gotta get tested, don't be hesitant. At the end, maybe you don't have nothing, but you can feel at ease that you might not be spreading nothing, you know. Especially if you feel like you came in close contact. That's why I'm getting tested at the end of the day. A good majority of my blood family, my sister got sick, she got real sick. My mom has it, she lost her taste of smell. Her taste and smell. My mom's husband got it. I was just talking to him on the phone. 3 days later, he still has a real high flu. Hasn't been able to get up out of bed. Pretty much my sister was the same way. Then I heard my grandma got it, but she's cool. She just has a bad cough. She's an older lady. She's diabetic. I heard her household, a couple members of her household got it. So at the end, like I said, I talked to my grandma for a little bit, real minimal. And pretty much, I just want to make sure I'm safe, keep my family safe, you know, and others around me safe. Now, if I'm to catch it, then I'll do whatever is necessary if I have it. I mean, like I said, I don't feel sick right now, but we'll go from there. Looks like the guy's coming up right here. He's coming up. One of the doctors, we'll see how it goes. I guess my sister was telling me they stick something through your nose, and they also do a swab, a mouth swab, saliva swab. If you're contemplating about going to go get checked, maybe this video will give you some strength, some support, you know, because I'm hesitant too. I told my wife I ain't gonna get checked if I don't feel anything, but you know, might as well. Why delay? I got here at they open at 9. I made the appointment luckily at 6 through the website, the Kaiser Permanente website, and they told me it opens at 9, but I heard it gets real packed. So I've been here since 7:30. Looks like the line's moving now. It's like 8:53 on my clock, Western Pacific time. Up, lines moving. I guess there was like 20 cars. I spoke to the security earlier. We're out here at 7:40. She said it opened at 9, but there's about 20 cars ahead of you. It's supposed to be a drive-through. Este video es para la gente. Voy a hacer un COVID test en español. Lo voy a cambiar para que la gente entienda también, toda la raza. No sé qué está pasando, nos están mandando a otro lado. Pero cosa que está pasando aquí es que me vengo a hacer el examen porque mi familia salió mala, salió positiva, mi hermana, mi mamá, su esposo de mi mamá salieron malos. Y pues al fin del día no los ha mirado a ellos como en 3 semanas o en ese aspecto, pero miré a un miembro de mi familia, a mi abuelita, el domingo pasado, un ratito, hoy es domingo, el domingo pasado la miré mínimo. Y ella el miércoles oí. Hi.
Thank you so much, sir. I appreciate that. Oops. And your phone number. And did you have a telephone visit, an e-visit, a doctor's visit?
I did an e-visit.
Okay. And they ordered the test for you?
Yes, they said your test
okay,
has been ordered.
Okay, do you have symptoms of COVID?
No, I haven't had any.
Exposure?
That's what it was. I talked to my grandma minimal on last Sunday.
Uh-huh.
Real minimal, not even like 5 minutes, uh-huh. I think. But then I heard on Wednesday she was tested positive. Okay. So
what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this in your car window. You're gonna keep your windows up, and you're gonna stay quarantined until you get your test results.
Okay.
Okay. And good luck with everything.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Take care.
Oh, watch out. So there you go. I gotta stay quarantined till I get my results. Tengo que estar encerrado hasta que agarre mis resultados. Para la gente, como les digo, mi mamá estaba bien mala, mi hermana. Bueno, mi mamá estaba bien, lo que pasó con mi mamá, ella agarró. No puede probar ni hueler, pero está bien. Mi hermana no puede probar ni hueler, le duele el pecho. Ya ahorita anda mejor, esto era desde el domingo, pero hasta ahorita le duele el pecho, pero ella se puso muy mala de la fiebre, muy mala. Hasta se miraba en la cara. Y el esposo de mi mamá también, desde el domingo anda bien malo y ahorita no se ha podido parar de la cama. Y lo triste, pues que no podemos ir a verlos, ellos andan encerrados. Y pues miré a una familiar el domingo, unos familiares, hablé con ellos muy rápido, tenía mi máscara yo, ellos tenían su máscara, pero me di cuenta que el miércoles fueron positivos. Yo me siento bien, pero no quiero arriesgar, ¿verdad? Por mi familia, por mañana mi trabajo, yo trabajo en la construcción, soy carpintero, y pues a mis compañeros no quisiera yo, es más pedo, en veces. Tal vez no tengamos nada y decimos no tenemos nada, pero el problema es o nos sientamos bien, pero yo mi opinión es que en veces como si tengo algo y no sé y voy al trabajo y ellos no traen nada, ¿verdad? Como ya me expuse técnicamente a alguien que la saludé y me expuse a ellos. So para mi seguridad de mi familia, de mis compañeros y si puedo ir a trabajar a gusto, mejor. Ya teniendo mis resultados, no traes nada, mejor me voy. Y si sí, pues hago lo necesario que tengo para cuidarme a mí y a mi familia. Y a mis compañeros, amigos y sea lo que sea. Y estaba muy, muy terco yo en querer venir también. Yo soy de los que dicen nada va a pasar. Pero este video ojalá ayude a los que piensen igual que yo. Para seguridad de otros, si no es para el fin de uno, para la seguridad de otros. Para respeto de otros, para respeto de otros, ¿verdad? Yo esa es mi opinión. Yo no quiero, como técnicamente me expuse, I was exposed, no quiero, ya fui a trabajar, pero digo, pues, mejor me chequeo yo mismo, para saber, para estar seguro. Y si tengo algo y ya fui a trabajar esos días antes de que supe, porque yo me supe que el miércoles, yo estaba bien, pero no supe hasta que quedé en contacto con mi familia. Hasta el miércoles me di cuenta. Pero ya no la pensé, dije, no, pues, hasta ayer, dije, no, pues, hablé con ellos el sábado también, y me puse a pensar, ¿verdad? Pero dije, si de veras agarré algo, y mis compañeros de trabajo también no traen nada, es mejor que sepan, ¿verdad? Y se chequeen si de veras yo tengo algo. Pero primeramente Dios no, ¿verdad? Pues aquí estoy en la Kaiser. I'm right here on Kaiser right now. Y este video pues también lo hago para los que estén desanimados a venirse a chequear, o digan que no traen nada, o traen poquito medio, o cualquier excusa o no excusa, nomás miedo, o sea lo que sea. Como les digo, yo también la andaba pensando de más, y al fin dije, ¿sabes qué? Voy a ir. ¿De qué miedo? Y ojalá pues todos los que estén en duda sientan que mejor la están pensando. Ojalá este video les ayude a venirse a chequear. Hopefully this video helps those in doubt or thinking about it or wanting to or just scared. Hopefully this video helps you. You know, like I said, I was thinking about it. It's not that I was scared, but I was being more stubborn about it. Hopefully it gives you some courage, un ánimo. Yeah. I'm right here right now under the garage. Aquí están todos los nurses. The nurse ahorita me dijo, no salgas hasta que agarres tus resultados. So, así lo voy a hacer. So, técnicamente le tengo que llamar a mi empleador ahora, domingo, y le voy a decir que mañana, a causa de esto. Y pues, ojalá pues todo sea bien, ¿verdad? Si técnicamente mañana no voy a trabajar, ojalá hasta que me den mis resultados. Ahí tengo que hablarle. Y pues ya de ahí nos vamos. Nos vamos y nos movemos de allí. Pero, como les digo, ojalá este video pues ayude a alguien. Tal vez que, porque como les digo, en mi propia familia había gente media que no quería chequearse, pues. Y al fin del día se fueron a chequear y resultaron ser positivos y andan bien malos. Y hay otros que ha habido que no se han querido chequear, pero como ha dicho, no que pensar nomás que en nosotros, se dan veces. Nuestras madres, nuestros hermanos, nuestros tíos, nuestras tías, nuestros primos, ¿verdad? Mucha gente está tirando fiestas y dicen que así se está haciendo todo esto, ¿verdad? En las fiestas, en las reuniones, donde hay mucha gente y sin máscara, ¿verdad? Mucha gente no está usando máscara, pero primeramente Dios, pues que aprendamos de esto. Hay que aprender y antes de que Dios no quiera les llegue a su casa, pero hay que aprender a cuidarnos y a tener respeto antes de que llegue a nuestra casa. So, un familiar, porque al fin del día no sabemos. Como les digo, mi madre no está mala, pero perdió su no puede probar ni hueler. Y mi hermana sí se puso bien mala. Hablé con mi abuelita y ella dice que no se siente mal, pero que trae una tos muy fuerte, pero que se siente bien. Cada quien le va a pegar diferente, ¿verdad? Según es la teoría, como se dicen, como se oye. Pero mejor pues hay que chequearnos. Check out my other videos. Chequen todos mis videos on YouTube. Sideways. You know, it's called Sideways. But I added the ENT because it pops out easier on the. But it's more like a TV podcast, music. It's pretty much everything. That's what I'm gonna base it on. But check my videos out. I have some music on there. Hopefully you guys like. SideWayzENT. But it's basically, in reality, it's just sideways, period. Sideways. I just said, like I said, I added the ENT. just for the YouTube purpose. But it's sideways. Got the guy next door explaining something to the guy in front of me, one of the nurses or doctors, explaining something to the car in front of me. Like I said, it's 9:05, ya son las 9:05. Llegué aquí a las 7:30, 7:40. Cuando llegué, le dije a la security, le dije, hey, ¿cuántos carros hay enfrente de mí? Dijo, abren hasta las 9, pero tienes como 20 carros adelante. Como a la media hora, a las 8, habían como unos 100 carros atrás de mí ya. Bueno, a la vista sí se mira, ¿verdad? No sé, pero yo creo ya, ahora sí, ya son las 9. Sí, estoy un poco nervioso, pero pues, I'm a little nervous, but let's do it, you know. I'm already here. I can't reverse. I can't reverse. It's hard to see, but there's a lot of cars behind me. I didn't think this was gonna be a long video, but I'd rather record everything. You know, I'd rather record everything. I'll edit it as best as I can to shorten it up. But that way you guys see it through here, what it's like to get tested for COVID-19. Like I said, I'm doing it for at the end. If I lived by myself, I probably wouldn't be here. If I lived by myself, I probably wouldn't be here. I wouldn't care. Maybe. But I'm doing it for respect to my family, respect for others.
Hi. Are you, what is your name?
Luis Valencia.
Okay, and can you verify your date of birth?
August 3rd,
1988. Okay, and you are having a saliva.
Saliva?
Yeah.
Okay.
Make sure you quarantine afterwards, keep your window up, and then you'll go through the line.
They don't do the nose one no more?
They're not going to do the nasal, it's spitting in okay.
A... Thank you. Well, I guess they're not going to put nothing through my nose, so that's good. That's good. I guess my sister, they did two on her. They did two up both her nostrils and the saliva one. I don't know why. Lucky for me, it's only a saliva one. Ahí está mi gente. Para que no se preocupen. Bueno, a mí, así me están diciendo. No me van a meter nada a la nariz. Es por pura saliva. Voy a escupir en un vasito, dijo. So, para que no se asuste la gente, a lo mejor ya está cambiando las cosas, o ya hay más facilidad para hacerlo, pues. O no sé quién o por qué se los están metiendo en la nariz a unas gentes. A lo mejor es diferente en todos lados. Pero hay para la duda, para si traen una duda, es más fácil. Técnicamente a mí va a ser por saliva. Voy a escupir. I'm just gonna spit. So there you go. You know, if you guys have some doubts about getting something through your nose, I'm only gonna do a saliva one. It took some nerve off mine, you know. They say it doesn't hurt that bad when it goes up your nose. But it makes it easier. Makes it easy. And I'll be honest. I did tell my wife, I'm not gonna check. No me voy a chequear, solo si siento algo. Por eso estoy aquí, porque la mera verdad, Ayer me bañé con agua bien caliente, ya como a las 5 o 6, y ya se está poniendo bien frío en la noche. Y me salí a la marqueta, así. Llegando a la casa, estuvimos como unas 2 horas afuera. Llegando a la casa, empecé a sentir aquí como angina, ¿verdad? Dije, ching, ya me dio algo. Pero yo sé que, yo en mi opinión, es porque salí así, ¿verdad? Pero dije, ni modo. Yo dije, voy a chequearme si me siento algo. Y pues aquí ando. I'll be honest, it's for all my viewers, Spanish and English speakers. Like I said, I did say I'm gonna check myself if I feel something. Last night I took a hot, warm shower, like around 5. We ended up going to the grocery shopping right after that. And once I got home in the cold weather after that warm shower, I started feeling like a sore throat, you know. So I woke up in the morning, I said, I'm gonna go. You know, I said, if I feel something, I'm gonna go. So I'm here now. But I didn't put that I'm feeling any symptoms, because I rather kind of also find out, you know, just a little thought I have out there. If I put I have symptoms, you're gonna say I have it. So if I rather say I don't have symptoms, I just put I was exposed to someone I think that had coronavirus. So we'll see from there, you know, we'll see from there. Como les digo, le voy a decir, piden que por qué están haciendo el test. Hay muchas razones allí. Si tengo síntomas, le puse que no tengo anginas, nada de eso, porque yo nomás por mi un razón, no sé por qué, pero dije, si pongo que tengo un síntoma, un dolor de cabeza, anginas, fiebre, me van a decir que sí tengo el virus, ¿verdad? Yo, mi opinión. Pero le puse que no, nomás le puse que estoy expuesto. Que estoy expuesto a una persona que lo tuvo. Así, pues, así, me van a decir derecho si tengo o no. Pero yo pienso que si digo que tengo un dolor de cabeza o algo, me van a decir que sí tengo el virus. Me están diciendo dónde parquearme. Así es, hay mucha gente. Está haciendo calorcito aquí adentro. Tomos por seguridad, aquí estoy, pero también yo estoy haciendo mi propio examen, ¿verdad? Técnicamente no quiero decir que tengo, me duele las anginas. Ahorita ya no me duelen igual que toda la noche, pero yo pienso que salí, es porque me bañé con agua bien caliente. Y salí, de repente me vestí y salimos a la marqueta y hacía frío y me fui sin suera. So I left without a shirt. Once I took that shower, got ready, left without a shirt to the cold weather outside. So this is a little dirty laundry I have to take out. So, you know, we'll see. That way, if they say, like I said, I don't want them to say that I have something because I put that. Yeah, you have something, but who knows? Who knows? We'll find out right now or later on, I guess. So, yeah, like I said, I'll try to edit this video as short as possible. I can see right here, it's already 26 minutes. Because I know a lot of us can't stand but can't really sit down to watch a 30-minute video. 40 minutes, whatever it is. I know I can't do that. As good as it is, I really don't. They give me some paperwork. So. I mean, it kind of feels like the movies, you know what I mean? In the movies and the video games. In the video games, there in the movies, there's a lot of these doctors, easy ups, checking people, you know? But hopefully it's all for our best too, you know? Hopefully this is a learning experience for all of us. For all the world, because I guess the whole world is going through this. Who knows, you know, maybe this is just supposed to be a learning experience for us. It's a good price to pay because, from my understanding, a lot of people are dying. Yeah. I know there's more diseases going out there. There really is. There really is. There's other diseases, you know, there's people still fighting cancer, there's people still with diabetes, there's still people with heart disease, brain disease, asthma, people going through strokes, there is, you know, we can't forget. In reality, this isn't the only thing going on, but it's just... obviously, because it spreads, I guess, you know, it spreads. Cancer doesn't spread from one person to another, you know what I mean? Diabetes doesn't spread from one person to another. Heart disease, the brain disease, and, you know, there's people that are going through getting in accidents that are staying paralyzed, you know what I mean? So this isn't the only medical issue, but it's something that's spreading, I guess, so, through the whole world. So, I understand there's other things, other people dying from other stuff. And my prayers and my blessings to everybody else going through whatever they're going through. All these workers right here, nurses, doctors, doing their thing, you know, mi respeto to everybody. Still, you know, a lot of these people don't want to be here. They got their families too, they're worried, but mi respetos, because you're doing it for everybody else, you know. If it weren't for you, for the job you have, we wouldn't be being helped at all, you know. So my saludos, my respetos, to my hat down to all you medical workers, frontline workers doing your thing right here, you know. And I hope you get repaid fully for your work.
Thank you so much for waiting. I appreciate it. My name's Melissa. I'm going to be walking you through your test today.
Okay.
I'm just going to have you go over these instructions while I get your specimen ready.
Okay, thank you.
You got it.
Okay, did you give me my instructions? Saliva test instructions, step one, through funnel, fill container with saliva to wavy black line. Remove funnel, replace with cap, tighten the seal and release solution. Step 4, shake for 5 seconds. Step 5, clean hands with the wiping. Cool. So técnicamente tenemos que llenar un vasito hasta la línea negra, taparlo bien, bullirlo por 5 segundos y lavarnos las manos. Esas son las instrucciones para el saliva test. Aquí dice back, dice wait until you get your result. You should act as if you are COVID-19 positive and remain in your home unless there is an emergency. Técnicamente, hasta que agarres mis resultados, tengo que estar como si tengo COVID-19. No puedo salir hasta que agarre mis resultados. Y lo demás, pues es instrucciones de cómo cuidarse. Pero sí, técnicamente tengo que, como decir, tengo el virus hasta que me den los resultados.
So we're gonna start step one. You're just gonna spit into this funnel, collect your saliva all the way up to this black line. After you're done with that, you're gonna remove the funnel, screw this cap on, it's gonna break the seal and the fluid's gonna drop. Just keep tightening until it does that. Shake for 5 seconds, turn your emergency lights on when you're done, and we'll come back and collect your vial.
Sounds good.
For now, just keep the windows rolled up. If you have any questions or if you get to any stops, just turn your e-lights back on.
Okay, sounds good.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. El vasito. Llamero. Distribuyéndolo, tiene un químico que hasta que se aprieta se suelta. Distribuyéndolo por 5 segundos: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Aprender las luces de emergencia. Se hizo azul. Estoy esperando a que vengan. Hace calor. Super hot.
you're done with yours?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, cool, man. Thank you. One second, okay?
Yeah.
Results are going to be posted in the next 48 to 72 hours. Just keep an eye on KP.org.
Okay.
Try to stay quarantined just because we don't know if you're negative or positive yet. Did you have any other questions for right now?
No, that's it.
Okay, just call us if you have any that pop up later.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Luis.
Have a good one. Okay. Ya oyeron. Ya oyeron, ya oyeron. I guess I have to stay in quarantine for 4 days till I get my results at least. 48 to 72 hours. Wow. Wow. 48 a 72 horas. Me están diciendo que en veces los agarran en un día. Pero, pues ahí está mi gente. A todos ustedes, ahí está. Nomás escupiendo un vasito. Y pues ya, esperemos a ver qué me dicen. Si estoy sano, gracias a Dios. Y a seguir adelante. Y a cuidarme. Y a cuidar a otros, a respetar. Y si estoy malo, pues que Dios me sane. Y a cuidarme. ¿Verdad? Yo les dejaré saber los resultados cuando los agarre. Voy a tratar de poner este video lo más pronto posible. Cuídense. Cuiden a su familia. Peace. Sideways. Mouse.